sports. It's in the game.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Just to let you know, we'll be going live in 1 minute. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Silver Side Hockey. My name is Shawnahue99, and that camera is adjusted terribly. Let's see what we can do here. Better. So, anyway, we're heading into week two here at Silver Side Hockey. Last week, we spoke a lot about player builds, a lot of what the stats do, and then we just kind of dicked around and we played a little bit of OTP. This week, I think we're probably going to continue with a little more OTP. And we're really going to continue just kind of going over the analysis of our game as we play. And as well, we're going to try and look for different ways that we can improve. I know it's going to sound really narcissistic, but I rewatched the video from last week. And there's definitely a couple things I can do to improve my commentary. First of all is if I just eliminate the word from my commentary, it's going to sound 1,000 times better. And just really want to engage a lot of the people that are watching this stream, just to see what kind of questions you may have about the game or any sort of things that you'd like to see. I know there's a lot of commentary out there that do the shootouts, offline GM. I was going to say online GM, but that would be boring as sin. Here's my first line, here's my second line, and you don't need to see that. Nobody needs to see that. So, sorry for the delay initially there. I've actually had to swap out the laptop I used to view the stream chat for this little mini HP EPC or whatever the hell you want to call them, and the thing is slow as sin. But, see, I'm still waiting for it to load, so I can't see how many people are watching, any sort of chat questions, things like that. So, this is quickly went from a live hockey stream to how much tech support can I do online. Okay, the chat's still loading, and that's not good. Welcome to professionalism at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. I think what we're going to do here now is, while we're waiting for that to load, let's just hop into a game. Let's just get something going here, and let's continue where we left off last week. We are 2-0 so far while streaming live, which is fantastic. I believe in the first round of chat, I said, you know, this is the road to Legend 3. Well, it still is. I think, you know what? Let me switch over to the other screen here, and we'll just go from there. There we go. That is much better. That is not my face, which I'm sure everybody's ecstatic about. So, let's go ahead and just take a quick look at player stats here. Once again, I know it's absolutely amazing. I think last year I ended up playing somewhere in the range of 600 to 700 games online, which to me is a lot. Like, that's a lot of time spent on this game. There's already guys in here that have got 400 games in the first month and are just crashing through. So I wish I had that much time, but I'm an old man now. I have taxes to worry about, and I gotta make sure my prostate is up to date, and I don't even want to think about that. You don't need to think about that. I'm sorry. Oh, here we go. There we go. Once again, we are live on NHLGuides.net. We are on the main page tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Check out NHLGuides.net if you're viewing this on the Twitch TV site. It is an absolutely fantastic site full of all the tips and tricks that I won't be able to teach you about because I am not nearly as good as the people that make those. I'd like to prize myself on being somewhat good at hockey since I've been playing since NHL 94, and I'm kind of dating myself with that, but some of the guys and some of the tricks that they can come up with and the moves that they'll show you is absolutely amazing. What do I want to look at here? Here we are. Performance tracker. Perfect. So far, the road to Legend 3 is still a bit of a slow one. It's not terrible. I mean, we're sitting at 75 games, an A overall, which isn't too bad. I think last year I was only a 2.21 point per game player, yet this year you're going to see... Oh, God, where is it? No, I want all skaters. Mind you, I have been playing defense. Where are we at? Oh, God. No, I want stats. There we go. Points per game, 1.63. That's not terrible, but, I mean, if you go at center... Oh, God. That's... Yeah. Enough about my player. Let's get into some action. Once again, live on the main page of NHLGuides.net. You've had to listen to me ramble for so long, and I apologize. So, let's back out here and let's get right into the thick of it. Once again, we do have our guy set up as primarily a center. All the other positions are set up, but I think just for viewing purposes, again, we're going to try and stick with the center here. Wait till one of these opens up here. I guess we could go into three, but let's just stick it out. Or we could join Pee Pee Touch. I don't know if that's good touch or bad touch. Probably bad touch. Okay. And screw it, we'll go into three. Should be only one game running here. 5 of 12. I'm gonna go on the side that has the legends, just because that seems like the smart thing to do. Also, I still adamantly believe that if you're the home team, you have a better connection. That always seems to ring true, and every time I think it's just a myth, I don't know, call me superstitious if you will, but that's just the way it is for me. Chicago. I don't even know what that accent was. And X-Versatile is so ecstatic to be finally playing that he's just going to go ahead and start jumping around. And we get center. Fantastic. Oh, son of... Oh, wow, okay. Not too often the first night goes like this, where you get the first game, but I'll take it. I gotta say, these Chicago jerseys are pretty sweet. Here we go. Lose the first face-off. Oh, that's right, we got a human goalie. So, here's something we didn't get to do last night, or last week, was actually play with a human goalie. If you play, or did we? Fuck, I can't remember. If you're playing with a human goalie, watching the cross crease is essential. It's up to the goalie to make sure that they're stopping the shot that could possibly be coming from the guy with the puck. You should always be watching for that cross crease and making sure. Ooh, left. Sorry, I completely lost my train of thought there. We're just going to keep going, and we're just going to start getting back into the play, setting up positionally and giving our D-man an out, and then getting rid of it. And hoping that the left wing will stop for the puck. I tried to get way too fancy there. So in case you're wondering, if you are wide open in front of the net with the puck against a human goalie, you should probably look for the pass. It's just the smart thing to do.